What matters to me is that I eat right the day before and I get the nutrients in that I need. Pullovers isn't really something that you want to just throw a whole lot of weight on. Episode 2 of the Swole Chest Chronicles is chest and back day. Starting off with dumbbell pullovers and push-ups this morning. Yes, training in the AM today. So that means that I'm training fasted. I usually don't eat breakfast. I usually wait till about noon, 1 o'clock to start eating. So training fasted this morning. Might see more of that, might not, but feeling strong, feeling energetic. Let's get started. The push-ups are a really great addition to the pullovers. Really good to superset with. Gets my chest warm. But another thing too is that push-ups are really underutilized. There's so many different ways you can do them. When I'm doing them right now, I do them in a way that, where I focus on doing them in a way where I can take my triceps out of the equation as much as possible. So what I do is I turn my hands out. How many degrees is that? Like 30, 45 degrees. Have my hands parallel to my chest. And I'll lift my thumbs up off the floor. And I'll do normal push-ups. For me, it helps take my triceps out of the equation as much as possible, because I'm not trying to feel them while I'm doing them. I'm trying to focus on my chest. Alright, all finished up with the dumbbell pullovers and push-ups. Had 3 sets. I think I was saying last week that I wanted to either add a set or increase the weight. I chose to increase the weight instead. So what I did was that instead of having 30 kilos as my baseline, I have 32.5 kilos as my baseline. Did that for 2 sets, and on the last set I increased to 35 kilos. So from now on, my baseline's gonna be 32 kilos. 32.5 kilos dumbbells. That's my baseline, and I'll increase from there. Want to add a set or not, that's up to me. I'll just feel it out, see how my body feels. If I'm at the end of my 3rd set and I'm not like pooped, I like to be pooped after every exercise, but if I'm not feeling pooped or like just done, then I have to add another set. Pullovers isn't really something that you want to just throw a whole lot of weight on. I'm gonna keep weight at a medium weight so that you're not losing reps. I'm not trying to go for strength here. I'm trying to build muscle. So I wanna have more reps. Even though you can build muscle with less reps, I do want more reps to get the most out of it. That's what works for me. Favorite part of the workout, got dumbbell incline bench here. This week, I've decided that I'm gonna use 42.5 kilos as my baseline. That's what I was working up towards the first few weeks. So 3 sets with 42.5 kilos. First set right now, I think I had 10, 11 reps. I'm gonna watch back. Second set, I counted 8. So if I can match that, this 3rd and last set, that'd be perfect. Really starting to find rhythm with it as well. Getting the weight up, setting myself up on the bench, breathing. So it's just getting better and better. So I'm just hoping that I can keep it up. Man, there's a lot of sun in my eyes. See if I can avoid that. Anyway, thing is, I probably shouldn't record with the sun in my eyes because I just look super pissed. Whenever I get light in my eyes, I start to squint. I'm really sensitive to light, so it's probably not the best idea for me to be sitting with the sun right in my eyes and recording looking pissed the whole time when I'm actually super happy. Chest portion of the workout's all finished up. I ended off with chest press. I decided to do something a little bit heavier today than what I usually do. Gotta put my monitor away again. But no, I decided to do something a bit heavier today instead of doing butterflies, which is a light isolation movement. I had a lot of energy, and that's the thing that's nice about my program. I can just move things around. But obviously I have my base exercises such as dumbbell incline bench and dumbbell pullovers, which are always going to be constant. So that last exercise is something that I can always switch in and out if I please. We're into the back portion of the workout. I started off with straight bar pull downs over there. 3 good sets to get my lats all warmed up and ready to go. And that's moving to somewhere else to record because it's a bit brighter in here. It wasn't working too well over there. Plus that, there's music playing. I'm not trying to get copyrighted. But anyway, I've got chest supported rows. This is my last exercise. And you know what? I'll just catch y'all over there. Enough of me talking. Alright, that's it for today's workout. Chest supported rows was the last thing I did. Yeah, I know the deal there as well. Just focus on growing my lats over this next mesocycle. It's all I care about. Just growing my lats. I know my upper back gets a lot of work and my lower back as well. But my lats are lacking. So that was all I was focusing on there. Just having that mind-muscle connection to where I pull and squeeze and I feel my lats. Because that's something I've sucked out during the past. A pretty good workout nonetheless, fasted as well, but for me, fasted training doesn't really mean much. What matters to me is that I eat right the day before and I get the nutrients in that I need, because they don't just, all the energy that you have during your days, they don't just appear out of nowhere. It's the cause or the effect of what you've been eating over the course of a few days, right? So me getting up training fasted, I don't really feel like it has much of a factor when it comes to my training. Obviously, it's a mindset thing too. Sometimes you might be a bit hungry in the morning, but for me, I just let that thought go, and I don't really like to eat unless I've done something, and then I feel like I, in a way, deserve to eat that food. I can't just get up in the morning and just eat and just chill. So I get lazy when I eat. Another thing too is that, I don't know if y'all see my skin, but it's not looking too good. I've done a bit of testing. I mean, it looks fine, but it's not at its best. But what I'm trying to say basically is that I've done a bit of testing and I allowed myself to eat a bit of sugar, a little bit more than usual. And I've noticed that my skin started to break out. And I don't know, it just goes to show, man, stay away from that stuff. Don't eat too much of it if you're a person that's addicted to it. I've noticed that I've been a lot more turned off to sugar than I have in the past. In the past, I'd always want to eat some type of sugar, but now I'm like really conscious of what I put in my body. So just stay away from the sugars. I don't know if y'all see it. I'm breaking out a little bit, my forehead and stuff. Could have to do with the durag as well, but I've just noticed that my skin isn't at 100%. That's enough for me. This was the Swole Chest Chronicles episode 2. Hope y'all enjoyed it, and as usual, I'll catch y'all on the next one.